Welcome to Java Forum. Now we are going to see how to install and configure Open Liberty 18 application server on Suse Linux Enterprise Server 12 edition. So still many users are using Suse Linux Enterprise Server 12. For them, this video will be useful. So here you can see that I already downloaded Open Liberty 18.zip file from Open Liberty website. So this Open Liberty 18 is a free to use and open source project from IBM. So I have extracted the content to /opt directory. So I am creating one new directory called Open Liberty 18 and I am copying that extracted content to newly created directory. So next I am opening the terminal and check whether Java is available in the terminal. So we are using Oracle JDK 8 to run Open Liberty 18 application server. Make sure that Oracle JDK 8 is available in the path. Next I am giving permission to the Open Liberty 18 application server directory. So Open Liberty 18 supports Java EE 8 standards. So this is the directory structure of Open Liberty 18 application server. Contains bin and lib directories. So this dev directory contains lot of jar files and lib directory contains jar files used by Open Liberty 18 server. Also this templates also available. So this we can see later. Now let me open the terminal. So now I am going to bin directory of Open Liberty 18 application server. So my first command will be /server create. So some instance name, I am giving instance name as Liberty Suse. So this command will create one instance called Liberty Suse. So here you can see that new directory called usr created. Under usr servers you can see that Liberty Suse instance is created, which contains apps, drop-ins and work area directory. So now I am going to start this instance called Liberty Suse by using the below command .server/server start Liberty Suse. So this will start the Liberty Suse instance in background. So here you can see that process ID is generated for this instance. I am grabbing that process ID. Yes, so it is up and running. Anyway, we need to check the logs whether it is started successfully or not. So that is a good habit. So I'm going to a logs directory which is created newly. So I'm opening messages.log. So messages.log is the complete log of Open Liberty instance. So here you can see that it started in the port 9080. So 9080 is the default port of the first instance you created. And console.log also available. So both log you can verify whether it started successfully or not. So everything is good here. Now let me open the browser to check whether I can able to access the Open Liberty 18 application server homepage. Yes, I can able to access the Open Liberty 18 application server homepage. So now I am going to stop the Open Liberty instance called Liberty Suse. So this is the command to stop the Liberty Suse .server stop Liberty Suse. This will stop the instance. Yes, instance is stopped now. So now I am going to execute the command called .server list. So this will list down the instances that are created under USR directory. So this will list down all the instances available ./server/list. So currently only one instance I have created. Next I am going to start the Liberty Suse instance in foreground. Instead of starting in background, I am starting in foreground. This is the command ./server/run/liberty-suse. So foreground process, you can stop this foreground process by just pressing Ctrl+C. Yeah, let me press Ctrl+C. Yes. So this is the use of this ./server/run command. So open Liberty 18 application server installation on Suse Linux Enterprise Server 12 is successful.